We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
One is monetizing and distributing your application. So let's start the first one, chapter number 15, or the first chapter in last unit, unit number 5, audio video using camera. So 5 topics are there: playing audio and video, manipulating the raw audio, using camera to take pictures, recording video, and adding media to the media store. So these are the 5 topics that we are going to cover in this thing. So let's select first playing audio and video. In Android, we have one class, that is the media player class. That class we can use to play either audio or video file available on our Android platform. So using media player, you can play media that is stored in any particular medium, like say that application resource file or the local file or a file available in content provider, or it is live stream from network URL, right? So you can access media wherever it is placed, and you can play that media either audio or video using media player class. Here, to do so, media player management of audio and video file that is handled by a state machine. State machine is nothing but a serial of steps, right, that is going to be followed to initialize the media player or to use the media player to play audio or video file. Basically, it includes 5 steps. These 5 steps are same for audio and video. So what are these 5 steps? Just see on your screen. First one, initialize the media player with media to play. Media can be anything, video or audio, whatever you can select. Then you need to prepare the media player for playback. Third thing, once you have prepared that media, you need to start the playback. If you wish to pause or stop before your media playing is completed, you can utilize this thing. And the fifth one, then playback is completed, right? So that you can utilize. Let's start one by one, initializing audio content for the playback. So this is the first step in our state machine to work with media player. So what we need to do, first we need to create the object of media player class, and we need to set the data source of audio. So just see the third bullet, we are hello.
Yes sir.
Sorry, Zoom che restart thai gelu pachu vache thi connection break thi gayu. Tame maro avaj sambhali sakta hata tyare ke nahi?
Na na sir.
Okay, atyare screen display thai chhe tamare ke nahi? So media player dot create a current context and audio source, right, that we need to provide in create method. So 2 arguments are there. First argument, that's a current context, so that you can utilize the get application context, or you can utilize that these or whatever you wish to, but a current context should be there. You can utilize the application activity name dot this. There are so many options to retrieve that context object. Okay, but what about the audio source? So as we have discussed that we can access audio from different sources. Just see a four different source that you can utilize that we are defining right here. First one, that we want to load our audio resource from our packet. So that in our packet, that means within our application, we have compiled this thing, right? So in a raw directory, we can place our audio file. So we are utilizing that thing. So just see here, second parameter we are utilizing that r.raw.myaudio. MyAudio is the name of our audio file. So how we are creating the media player object, resource player equal to media player dot create current context and the source, that is the audio source we are defining from the raw resource. So r.raw.myaudio. So that is the first technique. Now say that a media is available in SD card or the memory card and we want to play from there. So how we can do this thing? So just see another example where we are providing again a current context and we are passing the path of SD card where our local file .mp3 sound file is available, right? So what we are doing, uri.parse file colon, then we utilize this slash, then we give the path that SD card and just specify the local file .mp3. So it will take the resource from SD card. Next one that we want to play a URI. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
તમારે રજીસ્ટર્ડ થઈ છે કે તમારો બધાયને સેમ પ્રોબ્લેમ છે?
થાય છે સર મારે ભી.
કે બે વસ્તુ જો ભાઈ. ભગવાન કરે કે હવે
તમે બહુ વખાણ કરી નાખ્યા છે.
અરે હા 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 મને પહેલી વાર આવો પ્રોબ્લેમ થાય છે. વખાણ કરવાની જરૂર નથી. બહુ ખરાબ છે જૂમ હવે એમ કહું. ચાલો પાછી સ્ક્રીન શેર કરું છું, નહીં દેખાતી હોય તમને. Okay, so we are discussing the third technique, that from URL we want to play our audio, right? And the fourth one, right, we already discussed this thing, that how we can play our audio from any URL, like say that some file is available on some web host, say your domain is there, like say if I give my example, right, www.bipindupadia/audio/abc.mp3 file is placed and I want to play that particular thing, then with the help of media player dot create, current context need to be passed and that URL need to be converted in uri.parse, right? So in this way you can play this thing. Last one, that play video from content provider. So right here we are taking example to play the default ringtone whatever you have set for your device. So just see again, we utilize the current context and second parameter, that's a setting dot system dot default underscore ringtone URI, right? So here it will play ringtone from content provider. So we just see the four different techniques. Playing audio from package resource, that means the raw files, playing audio from the SD card, third thing, right, playing video, audio from the web, and the last one from the content provider. Okay, another thing, that once you create the object of media player, you need to call prepare method. But if you have created media player using media player dot create method, this create method already do the call of prepare. So if it is, if you are creating media player dot create method and creating your media player object, at that time you should not call prepare method again. Previously, in our previous slide, right, we are doing the same thing. So if you are using this technique, don't call prepare method again. But it is possible that you call or you create media player in this particular way. Just see the box of bottom of your slide, right, where we are just creating new fresh object of media player, but we have not mentioned anything, or we have not called the static create method. So at that time you need to call prepare. Just see that after setting the data source, media player dot set data source, it will specify that from where you want to play this thing. Again, these four type of resource that we have seen in a previous slide, that we can specify right here. But when you set data source separately, then we need to prepare, right? So what it does, it will check the connectivity, that file is available, and it will initialize the media player to keep it ready to play, right? So how you can utilize prepare? Always remember, if you are using media player dot create method, don't call prepare again, because create method automatically do the call to the prepare. Now the next one, preparing for video playback. Okay, in audio what happened, once it is prepared, then you can directly call media player dot start, right? So when you call the start method, it's start playing. If you want to pause it, you can utilize media player dot pause. If you want to stop it, you can call media player dot stop, right? So these are the methods that you can work with the audio. Now say we are not interested to play audio, but if you want to play video, so what to do? So again, the same situation, right? We can utilize our media player object to play video. But when you want to play video, you must specify the video surface where you want to play your video, because in an audio it is a just sound file, right? So it will play on physical sound attached with your device. But in the case of video, some visuals are there. So there are two alternatives for playback of your video content on Android device. That in a first technique, you utilize the video view class, and another thing, you create your own surface where you can play the video. So our easy and simplest thing, that you should utilize the video view class that encapsulate the creation of surface, and it allocate and prepare of video content using media player. So video view is a one widgets that you can utilize to play video easily. But what if you wish to create your own media player? Okay, so to do this kind of custom task, you can utilize the second technique, that is allow your own surface and manipulate underlying data that is come from the media player instance directly. That means you need to create your own surface where you can play your video. Okay, so two techniques, video view and the surface view. Let's take first technique first, playing video using the video view class, right? So it's a simple technique. We can utilize it once we have created our activity on view. We need to drag video view and place over there, so that we can refer using find view by id. Just see the first line, right? R dot id dot video view, that we are setting the instance of video view object. Then once we find that Java reference of the video view, we can set the path. Again, is like the audio, we can utilize the four different sources from where you can play your video, either from the raw file, either from the SD card, or you can say the content provider or the web URL, right? That you can set. Here we have two methods to set the video, that is set video path and set video URI. Within that, if you are using the URI, file URI or the web URI, that you can specify over there. And if you are specifying the particular file path available on SD card or the internal storage, you should set this thing, right? So how you can set the source of video to video view, that we are just specifying right here. Now, once you have set the video, you can set for more functionalities, certain methods are there to control the playback, video playback using video view. That's our topic, right? So just see in a first line, we are just referring the video view. Second thing, while video is playing, you want to keep your screen on, right? So it will not just lock the screen. So method is video view dot set screen on, and you just specify true over there, right? So it will keep on your screen. Another thing, the path we are specifying, we want to play mycatvideo.3gp available on SD card. And the in a last thing, we just see the certain feature of media controller. Okay, so what is media controller? Media controller is basically used to control the media that you are playing. Media here in a video view, it's a video file. So how you can control it, right? So you can skip some video, you can pause your video, you can seek the video, you can stop it, you can restart it, right? This kind of function that you can do. So to do so, you need to create the object of media controller. So see second last line, media controller, we are creating the object of it equal to new media controller, and we pass the current context over there. Now we set the media controller to our video view. So see video view dot set media controller that we are specifying, and we pass the object of media controller, right? So a number of methods that you can utilize of video view, that is set video path to set the video source. Again, video URI, that is the another option, right? If you wish to play video from the web, start to start playing of your video, stop playback to make stop your video, pause to pause your video, seek to if you want to jump to halfway, or you want to forward your video or forward or backward, you can utilize this seek to methods. And we already see the last method, that is the set keep screen on, to make your screen on while playing the media. So these are the options that we can utilize. So we just seen in last previous two slide, right, that how we can play our video using video view. But what about the second option? That is create your own surface for playing video. So here what you need to do, you need to create the surface view object, right? You need to create your own surface where media player is able to directly play video on that particular surface. So first thing, you need to prepare it. The surface view class is the wrapper around surface holder object, right? So it will wrap that surface view where your video is going to be played, which in that particular wrapper, a surface view is used to support all update and the background thread. That means buffering of video to do the media control and all the commands that you can fire on video, like the pause or the seek and all other thing that available here. So that you need to create your own, right? Why? Because we are creating our own surface. So video surface view object will support to wrap around the surface holder where your video is going to be played. So this player that can be used a surface holder object that hold the surface view. Surface holder will hold the surface view to display your video content and assign this set display method that you are interested to display your video on any custom surface. So how to do this thing? Let's see it. So just see, we are creating one view for playing video file. So here we are creating a one XML layout file. Just see, we have utilized linear layout. Two linear layouts are there. In our first linear layout, we have placed surface view. In surface view, we have specified the height and width. And weight we have provided, that is the 30% of the our screen. Then in another linear layout, we have specified three buttons: play, pause, and skip, so that we can utilize to do certain operation on that surface view where our video is actually playing. So this is the UI, right? How we are preparing the UI for our wheel. Now let's see that how we can create that thing in our activity. So of course we need to create our own activity. So here we have created our class surface view video view activity, that is extended from activity. So activities is the class from where we are extending it. And remember, we are implementing the surface holder dot callback, right? So it will provide certain methods to support the callback methods of video. Okay, so as we know, we have created the activity. So let's first discuss the onCreate method, then I will come to these methods, right? So just see, here we have onCreate method. So in onCreate method, we set the layout surface view video view holder, right? So that we have created right here, right, in our previous slide. So that view we set here in a set content view. Now another thing that just see that we are creating the media player object, new media player object that we are creating right here. So this media player reference is the activity level variable. Just see right here, we have defined this thing, media player and its reference, right? So that we are initializing in onCreate. Now just see the everything remaining that we are performing, that a surface view that we have specified right here, that we are referring it. Okay, so just see how we can do this thing. So final surface view object of it, and find view by id of that thing we have specified. Then certain property we are setting, let's say set keep screen on while playing, right? So that method we have utilized. Now the important thing start, surface holder, that's a class that we are creating with the help of surface view object, surface view dot get holder. So it will provide the holder class where your surface is going to be held. Now holder dot add callback to this. That means when you do the pause, stop, or resume, or the seek, all these things need to be done on this holder. Then another thing that we specified, that's a holder dot set type surface holder dot surface type push buffer. That means holder is able to buffer your video. And then we specify the fixed size of that thing. So holder dot set fixed size 400 by 300 pixel, right, where your video is going to be displayed. So this is the onCreate method. Within that, we initialize the buttons that we have created in our layout. Just see which one: play, pause, and skip. So that we are initializing its listener. When a play button is clicked, so it on click listener will call. Where we would like to do the media player dot start. Similarly, if user is clicking on pause, we want to do the pause. And if somebody is clicking on skip button, then we are just hitting media player dot seek to the mid of that file. So just see media player dot get duration. It will give the total duration of your video, and we are just dividing it to 2. So that jump to the halfway of your video. So this is the on create method that we have discussed. Now let's again come to the first slide of where we have started our activity. Just see, we have implemented the surface view, surface holder dot callback. So that callback have 3 methods, right? It's an interface, right? So we need to override these 3 methods. So just see, first one, surface created. So when surface created method is called, what we are going to do, we need to specify media player dot set display, and that holder object we need to pass. So it will bind the surface holder to our media player. Then here, when surface is created, we want to bind our video source. So media player dot set data source, we are specifying that, okay, from SD card attest 2.3jp I want to play. And finally, we call the prepare, right? We utilize the data source, that's why prepare is need to be called. If you use media player dot create method, we don't require prepare need to be called. If anything wrong is happened within this try and catch block, right, it will caught in exception block, right? So that is the thing that we have in surface created. 2 other methods are there: surface destroy. That means if activity is killed or you press the back, what we need to do, so media player dot release, so at that time it will release the resource. If surface is changed, where this kind of thing is happened, like when you rotate your device, right? So what happened, height and width of that surface is changed. So at that time you can change its aspect ratio, right? Just see, they have the parameter that surface holder reference is there, then the format is there, width and height is there. So you can update certain parameter over there. But right now in our example, we are not doing anything special. So in this way, you can set the custom surface where you can play your video using media player. Do you have any doubt in this thing? This is the typical thing, right? If you are not interested to customize the player, you can always use the video view. That's a fast and simple option. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Doubt hoy to kyo kon? Yes, sir. Kitu? Okay. Another thing, that is how you can control the media player playback. Right? You just see a black screenshot is there where you can move your video to backward, forward, or you just do the play and pause. You can seek the video on some different positions, right? So how you can attach this viewer to your video view? So this is possible with the help of media controller. Okay, so we are creating the object of media controller, and then we need to specify to the video view. So just see, video view dot set media controller, and we pass that media controller objects over there. Now in a media controller, you need to specify that what it can do. So media controller, right, that's the object of media controller dot set media playback, and we are creating the anonymous reference of media player controller. So all these event, right, that you can do right here, we need to specify. So just see, they have lots of method. Boolean can pause, so we are returning true. Okay, you can pause your video. Can seek backward, return true. You can seek your video backward. Same way, seek forward, so you can forward your video. Get buffered percentage, right? So buffering zero, that is there. Get current position, so you can obtain the media player current position. Get duration, it will provide the total duration. Is playing, it will say a boolean true or false, that video is playing or not. Pause, you can pause this thing. And seek to specific position, that you can do. And finally, that start, right? So all these operations that you can perform using media controller. Right now, 40 minutes of the current session is over. So I generate new link and just mail you. Please rejoin it again, okay? Hello, are you getting my voice?